Pennsylvania is a key battleground state in the presidential election. And across the state, citizens are starting to vote. Like many Americans, voters in crucial counties like Erie are making tough decisions about going to the polls in person or sending in their ballots by mail.
Can we just drop these off here?
You sure can.
I'm dropping off some voter registration request forms. My parents live with me. They're in their 80s, and they're a little concerned about going and voting with the COVID situation. So we're just dropping those off so that they can vote at home.
I'm planning on voting in person. With the Postal Service changes coming in play, I'm afraid that my vote would not get there and be counted accurately. I am a little concerned about COVID, but I will do my best to protect myself and others.
President Donald Trump has cast doubt over mail-in voting.
Democrats are also trying to rig the election by sending out tens of millions of mail-in ballots using the China virus as the excuse for allowing people not to go to the polls.
But election officials say his allegations of fraud are unfounded.
There is some level of irresponsibility for undermining the process of the elections that we use in this country.
And we are still emptying.
No matter how somebody applies for a ballot, once they receive a ballot and that ballot comes back to Erie County, there's virtually almost no way that somebody could vote more than once. And the person that does vote, we verify their name, their address, their signature. All of that stuff has to be present on the envelope that comes back, has to be secured, and then we make sure that the person is in the book that they voted so they cannot double vote at the polls.
What election officials here are worried about is how long it will take to count the mail-in ballots, a process they can't start until the polls close.
We had some challenges this year instituting a new voting system, particularly having the mail-in ballots, not because the process was a problem, but the manual labor that followed that process was the challenge.
During the primaries, it took them 10 days to count 33,000 ballots. That number could more than double in the general election. So Erie has asked the state to allow them to start opening envelopes and preparing them to be counted, a process known as pre-canvassing, before Election Day. But so far, the request has not been approved.
We anticipate that under the current process, unless the pre-canvassing is changed, it will probably take 7 to 10 days before we get the final result.
I asked for a mail-in ballot. I never got it.
They just went out last week. So
I want to vote.
You want, okay. I'll get you someone to help you, okay?
Okay, thank you.
One concern voters have in Pennsylvania is the secrecy envelope. This is an extra envelope that voters have to include when returning their mail-in ballot. If that extra secrecy envelope isn't included, the vote will be void.
Just bringing those in.
Even with all the changes, Anderson says he's confident in the process. What worries him is what could happen on Election Day.
One of the bigger things that is becoming a concern and building is this idea of potential, I think violence is too strong of a word, but the threatening presence of people at polling precincts to attempt to turn away voters or send some kind of a threatening message to not actually come out and vote. Now, we certainly also agree that anybody can come out and support a candidate or protest as they want because they have that First Amendment right to do that, but not to do it in a way that threatens somebody else's rights.